Hey, what does it say when a fighter fights on a weekend and it's Monday morning and he's back in the gym working hard like he didn't even fight? He's what, 10-0 now?
10-0, right?
Yeah. What a beautiful knockout. We watched it.
Thank you.
That he already has another date. Right?
Yes, sir. Didn't he just got signed by a major promotion?
He's got signed, everything, and now he's got another date.
So how does it feel to be part of the top rank?
September 21st, right?
Yeah, September 21st.
Feels badass. 10-0, how many knockouts?
It feels like I already achieved my dreams. I'm barely getting started. But it feels, it's no, I haven't achieved my dream, obviously, but like, I got signed, like, how do I say it? It's a stepping stone, you know.
Ready
it's
for
a
the
big
next challenge.
It's a big stepping stone in my life.
They love that knockout, huh?
You
dropped him twice.
Yeah, and they liked it.
He was a good fighter.
Yeah, he was tough. He was a rugged fighter. I didn't really think I was gonna be able to get him out of there like that early. You know, I thought maybe 5th, 6th. I wasn't looking for him, but then Vita started telling me like, you heard him, you know. So like, all right, fuck it, and I started following up, and yeah, he took the first knee. And then after when I came back again and I hit him with the uppercut, boom, I felt it on my knuckle, boom. That one had to hurt him.
And he went down.
Yes, and I thought,
the ref waved it off.
Yeah.
What's your record now?
10-0, 6 knockouts.
Let's go. Yes, you're getting stronger and stronger and better and better.
Thank God. I think that's my even better motivation, that every fight, you know, we're getting better. So it motivates me more to be like, let's go back to the gym and keep getting better.
Talk to me about Virgil's win over Boyacek.
That fight was
Where
bad.
Did you watch it?
I watched it on the phone. After the fight, we had left, and we threw it on the phone, and we were eating. We stopped eating. We stopped everything. We're in a little ass table. Me and my uncles cramped up, just watching the fight. Like, oh man.
Virgil won fight. Clearly. How did you score it?
Nah, Virgil won. It was tough, but Virgil won. He edged off. I feel like I started watching it at the 6th round. Out of the 6th round, I think I only saw him maybe lose one. And it was just like it was not even that he lost or nothing. But every other round, Virgil, stronger punches, cleaner punches. You could tell he had more of the will of, you know? Yeah, don't get me wrong. The Ukrainian had little good moments where he would land something, but Virgil would come right back, take it from him. Every single time he felt like he was gaining confidence, Virgil would take it from him. Even when he got dropped, not really got dropped, but they counted as a drop the last one. Virgil got up, was mad, started taking it to him, hurt him at the end of the round. Like, I thought Virgil won clear. It was tough, but I thought Virgil did more than enough for sure to pull that off.
And what do you think about Lindolfo's win?
Ah, man, that was a tough fight. The dude he fought was tough. I thought it was a good fight. I don't know. I really don't have too much words for that one. I just know that one was tough.
He's now 20-0.
Yeah, for sure. That one was a tough fight though on both ends.
What do you think of Virgil's win?
Oh man, that shit was badass. Fuck all the hate. I'm up. I can't cuss on here. Bro.
You can cuss on here.
Fuck all the haters.
Leo, Virgil won.
Yeah.
You sparred him.
Yeah.
He won clearly. What do you think of the fight?
It was a beautiful fight. It was probably fight of the year, and I have no doubt it's probably the fight of the year. But he did a great job, and I'm proud of him.
Louis, what did you think? You've known Virgil from the amateurs, right?
Point wise, I think Virgil won it by easily 1 or 2 rounds. But the fight, the whole complete fight, I think Virgil won it beautifully. Aside from the slips or knockdowns, I thought he looked good. He was boxing.
He dominated.
Yeah, exactly.
Everybody want to see a clean ass knockout or something.
Like a sweep.
We're all human, man.
Yeah, we're all human.
Listen, in any other sport, if you win by a point in the Olympics, you win by a split second. You still won.
Yeah.
You win.
And then, what I like most about it is how Virgil started boxing him too as well.
Punishing
him. Jack, boom. Boom. Fucking looking sharp, fast, strong. Yeah, fucking. The other dude was trying to throw something. He won't.
He's better than the zone commentators. Nah, I'm just playing. Shout out to Gabe Rosado, he did a good job.
No, because people are always used to like, even like you can tell myself, I'm used to seeing Virgil fucking knocking people out, you know? And then he showed us, man, he can fucking box just as great as he can fucking knock people out, you know?
Okay, Virgil and Crawford, break it down.
Virgil's bad, bro. Virgil's bad, he's strong. Crawford, I just think the thing about Crawford, and that's the thing that sucks about Crawford, is he's not gonna risk, kind of like, they're not gonna sit there and try to exchange or try to get into something. They're just gonna try to box you and keep it as safe as possible. And I think that's what's gonna make us, sometimes when you're when you got like people like Virgil, they're willing to take risks to win. But when you got people like them, these are the champions, they're gonna do just enough just to be with, like, just. And I think that's when, look at the Majumov Terence Crawford fight. He didn't try to risk nothing until finally in the last round, but they didn't really try to risk nothing. Nobody was willing to, they were just both kind of, it was boring.
Okay, so you got obviously Virgil. How do you see him winning that fight?
I see Virgil winning. Virgil's bad, bro. I wouldn't doubt it. Virgil could get him out of there. It's just that Terence Crawford is a bad dude too, but Virgil's fucking bad, bro.
Okay.
So I think, man, that fight would be badass, but.
Okay, what about Shakur and Zepeda? William Zepeda is like 31-0 with 27 knockouts, something like that.
I think the same thing with Shakur. Shakur's just gonna box. Shakur's just gonna try to, you know. Shakur's just gonna box, and it's hard to fight people like that. They're not willing to take risks because you're not really fight like.
Okay, so one. It's up to you to figure out the Rubik's Cube.
Yeah, and it's difficult because, okay, you got people, say for instance, when fucking Teofimo fought, what's his name, that dude, what's his name?
Sandra Martin?
No, Sandra Martin. There was another guy that kind of fought like that. He fought Lomachenko as well. The dude that Teofimo fought, he fought Lomachenko as well. Ortiz.
The Puerto Rican, yeah.
Ortiz boxed. He boxed Jermaine. Shit. But they didn't give it to him. And it just because when you're the champion, in order for you to win, you have to, and it's hard for you to win when you got somebody that's not, like, confronting you, you know? You got somebody that every single time you try to kind of, they're moving, it's very difficult. And then not only that, but then they're winning the rounds because it's just very, look at when Shakur fought fucking Edwin De Los Santos. Very boring. Every single time Edwin De Los Santos would commit, Shakur is really fast that he'll just counter him.
That's true. Where's Jose? All right, thank you, Chop. Always a great seeing you. Stay up.
Yes, sir.
Message to your fans.
Thank you, Ellie.
Reporting.